We're at St. Luke's Greek Orthodox Church in Broomall, Pennsylvania for the second round of the Greek Orthodox Basketball League playoffs. Hi, I'm Teddy Costins of Cosmos Philly, bringing you another edition of the Greek Orthodox Basketball League. We've got four big matchups here at St. Luke's today in the playoffs. In the first round, we'll have Holy Trinity of Egg Harbor, ranked number one, playing the St. Demetrius girls team, ranked number five. And then we'll have game two, which now features Holy Trinity boys team, ranked number one also, playing St. George, the number fourth ranked team of Media. In game three, we'll have the Evangelismos girls team of Philadelphia playing the girls team of St. Luke's, ranked number three. And in the final matchup, we'll have Annunciation of Elkins Park, ranked number two, versus the boys Evangelismos, ranked number three. Stay tuned for game action here at Cosmos Philly. They say that defenses win games, and Holy Trinity's on the path to win a championship. The final score today was 18-12. First place team, first ranked team, taking on sixth ranked Upper Darby in a great matchup. Coach, give us a few words about today and what happened.
I just want to say I'm really proud of these girls. They came out full force from the start of the game, kept it going the whole game, and you guys rocked it. You worked together so hard all season, and we're super proud of you, and we're taking it all.
Anyone else want to throw something into this? Anyone? Any of the players? Here we go.
Well, we couldn't have done it without our coaches, so thank you, Coach Stados and Janos. Girls did awesome. Great job.
There you have it. We'll see you at game two from St. Luke's in Broomall, Pennsylvania. They came out slow, but they took command in the second half after they caught up at halftime. A 42-34 victory for Holy Trinity. It's on to the big game. Two teams from Egg Harbor will now be in the championship game next week in Upper Darby. Coach Panetta, give us a couple of words about what happened today. It was a great effort.
Well, first things first, I have to congratulate St. George Media on a fine season, on a fantastic season. Going from not making the playoffs a year ago to giving us a run for our money today, hats off. I have a lot of respect for those boys, especially the seniors. I wish them all the best. For us, you know, this has been a goal for the past few years. We've made it to the semifinals the last 3 years. We've never broken through. Our church, the boys team, has never been to the finals before, so this is a tremendous accomplishment, not just for our boys, but for our whole community. I couldn't be prouder of them. John Lyakopoulos, four quarters, the kid had a migraine on the way up, and I was like, uh-oh, maybe, but he played his butt off today. And, I mean, our leaders on the court, Roman, carried this team, and obviously Vasile. I've been teasing them for a while. I said, you know, you guys realize you shoot 11% from the three-point line.
It seemed like it came alive the second quarter. Was there a little conversation? What did you tell them at the end of the first quarter to get them going?
At the end of the first quarter, I just tried to wake them up a little bit. I pulled them away so that nobody would really hear what I had to say. But they really, you know, they came out a little bit flat in the first. I think, you know, I don't know, maybe it was the bus ride. I don't know what it was. But in the second quarter, we picked up the tempo a little bit, and we really threw them off their game plan, I think. We kind of forced them to play our style of game. And that's really what turned the tide. That's really...
Anyone want to say anything?
How about the seniors? Two seniors.
Guys want to give us a couple of... Go ahead, say something.
It's been a crazy ride. 6 years.
Finally got the ship.
You guys ready for the big championship?
Yeah. I think I'm ready.
Yeah.
We gotta work hard. Really hard.
I'm here with Vasil, who threw in a tremendous amount of buckets. He started out real flat the first quarter, but he came alive. Vasil, what happened at the end of the first quarter? What did you do to put yourself into the game and start scoring for the team?
The whole team started working together. It's not me. I mean, you know, basketball is a team sport, so the whole team started moving around and passing the ball, and just my shot got in, and, you know, it's a team effort.
Okay, what exactly did you do? Did you change anything about the pattern of your shooting, or did you just continue to work at it and hopefully it would come about?
I guess I worked at it because, I guess I warmed up and, you know, my wrist got a little hot and the shot got in.
In a thrilling finish, 32-22, St. Luke's will be going on to the championship game next week in Upper Darby. Coach Chris, how'd it go today?
One more time, our defense came through. Stephanie had an amazing game today. She played great. The whole team played great. I'm so proud of all of them.
Tammy?
Unbelievable second half of the game. Absolutely proud of these girls. Congratulations.
Coach Chris, were there any changes made at halftime that made a difference?
We start pressing a little bit. Halftime, we start pressing the ball high. It make it a little different. We create some turnovers.
Anyone else want to say something? Any of the girls? Miss Raptis.
We are a family.
There it is. It's a family victory. On to St. Demetrius next week. Congratulations to St. Luke's. We'll see you at game four. First, let me congratulate Annunciation on an incredible victory, 46-39 over Busselton's Evangelismos Church. Let me come over here to Yanni. Yanni, give us an idea of what happened. What did you do real well?
You know, what we wanted to come out doing was, you know, just attack them, you know, play hard the whole game, you know, and just be able to weather them off. We knew they were a tough team. We know that, you know, our team has plenty of talent all throughout the lineup. We would be able to handle them, and, you know, we did. Thank God.
Wonderful. Nico, this is a little bit of a repeat for you, but now you're a coach. Give us a few words about today.
I wish I could play again. I mean, I loved it last year, but these guys are doing great. You know, hopefully another repeat for these guys. They played unbelievable today. Good job, guys.
Were there any adjustments at halftime, or was pretty much you kept the sync the whole game?
We started off 3-2 or 2-3 at the beginning, and we kind of went man because ball pressure, it causes them to turn over, and then it helped us a lot.
And now the speedster, George. Tell us what happened today.
Well, it was a good team win. Everybody scored today. Everybody played hard. Everybody played defense, which is where all of our offense started. When you play good defense, we play good offense. And Steph, Laz, Jim, everybody on the bench, Giorgio's fighting hard. We were all just, it was a good team win, and we'll be ready to go next week in the championship. So,
Was there an idea here to run the ball the whole game? Because it seemed like anytime you guys got a chance, you picked it up and you went flying down the court.
Well, we're a quick team. So when we have the chance, we will, but we're also good in the half-court offense. So we have a lot of threats, different things that we can do. So.
Anyone else? Well, there you have it. Elkins Park, congratulations. We'll see you next week at the championships.